all of the debris at Ground Zero was removed, it left a crater 7 stories deep and nearly a quarter mile across.
That human scale, that sense of loss, people said, don't build anything there. The whole site should just be a memorial. You had others who thought that we were focusing too much on the past and not enough on the future. And of course, a lot of people said, we can't build tall in New York or in America anymore. Look what happened.
Since September 11th, 2001, the world has been waiting for signs of progress at Ground Zero, asking the question, how will America respond?
It was a rainy November day, and one of the engineers said, does anyone want to go to the site? And we were all looking down at the site, and everybody said no. But I said, I'd like to go down. And I have to tell you that my world changed. As I descended some 75 feet down to the bedrock, I suddenly had a revelation.
At the very bottom of the hole, created by the fallen Twin Towers, architect Daniel Liebskin searched for a way forward.
When I went down there, I suddenly saw this was not just a site to be rebuilt. Almost 3,000 people perished. This site is such a great, passionate wound. That's why people care that this void in New York ceased to be a void, that it is filled with something memorable, something that will heal that space. But you have to create a balance between tragedy and hope.
After years of debate, study, and design, Liebskin's revelation at bedrock became a master plan, a vision that would honor the fallen and lay out a future for a new World Trade Center.
My idea was not to build on the space where people were murdered, to leave that space completely open, to leave it as a memorial.
The footprints of the missing Twin Towers will be transformed into the two largest man-made waterfalls in North America. The names of each 9/11 victim will surround them, so families and all people have a place to mourn those who died that day. The memorial pools will be surrounded by an 8-acre park, filled with trees relocated from the sites of the other attacks that day, at the Pentagon and the crash site of Flight 93 in Shanksville, Pennsylvania. A new museum will be built to tell the story of September 11th. It will surround two steel columns known as tridents, the only intact remnants of the original Twin Towers. The master plan will create a new gateway, a central train station that will welcome a million visitors and commuters every week. For Liebskin, the key to a new World Trade Center was not to simply reconstruct the Twin Towers as they were.
One of my ideas was to distribute density into 5 buildings and create a spiral very much analogous to the spiral in Lady Liberty's hand of the Torch of Liberty. You will see a spiral ascending to the tallest building, Tower Number 1.
Tower 1 will rise 105 stories to a staggering 1,776 feet, 400 feet taller than the Twin Towers. The tallest and strongest building in American history.